All right, all right. Well, I guess we'll get started. We're going to do Revelation chapter 12 today. You're going to need 400 pieces of paper and 1,000 pencils because everything happens in this chapter. It's a really cool chapter with a lot of stuff going on.
Mommy.
He ended chapter 11 with this great feeling of excitement. What was that?
You better draw things tiny.
Yeah, you're going to have to draw things tiny because of how many things we're going to have to fit in. We ended chapter 11 with this thanking God, the Almighty, because of all the things that he's done and his judgments, and that the temple was opened and people could see into the covenant, the Ark of the Covenant and the promises of God, and there's lightnings, and it was just this really wonderful thing. And God was in heaven. And it was a very good ending of chapter 11. So now we're going to move back in. And in a lot of ways, what's going to happen here in chapter 12 is something that we're going to see that happens a bunch of times in later on in the book of Revelation, where a story is told, and then it zooms into a part of that story and retells it, and then it might even zoom in even farther, and that sort of a thing. For instance, in Genesis chapter 1, it says that God created everything, and it even says, let us create man in our image, and it says, male and female, he created them. And then in Genesis chapter 2, we get the story of God creating Adam and Eve. So it's not like he made Adam number 2 and Eve number 2. Instead, it tells the story of all the creation in Genesis 1, and then in Genesis 2, it tells the story of just that little part of creation, of Adam and Eve. And that's what we're going to get a little bit of here in chapter 12. And what's fun is the story in chapter 12 is a little bit different. And you need to figure out, wait, where is it zooming back to and looking at? So as I start reading in chapter 12, and as you're reading along, you can draw little pictures and all. But think about what story is being told here in chapter 12. All right. And a great sign. Right, so that's just a vision. There's going to be a lot of signs and visions in this chapter. A great sign was seen in heaven, a woman arrayed with the sun and the moon under her feet, and with upon her head a crown of 12 stars. And she was with child, and she cries out, travailing in birth, and in the pain to be delivered. All right, we'll stop there. So we have a lady, and what sort of a mood is she in?
Having a baby.
She's sad because she's having a baby and she's crying and crying out. Ouch, 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 ouch. And she's got tears. And it sounds like she's beautiful because she's wearing the gold and she's wearing the stars and she's wearing the sun. But she's, well, you know how we drew the big fat belly. Well, we can give her a belly. Not that she's fat, but she's got this baby inside. And so she is crying out because she is about to have a baby, okay? So that's one of the signs. And there was seen another sign in heaven, and behold, a great red dragon having 7 heads and 10 horns, and upon his heads, 7 diadems. I don't know, oh my goodness. We're gonna have to draw this on the back because there's just a lot going on. And his tail draws a third of part of the stars of heaven and did cast them to earth. And the dragon stood before the woman, which was about to be delivered. And then she was delivered, he might devour her child. And she what? All right, so that's where we'll stop there for a moment. Okay, so what we have here, oh my goodness, we gotta already start drawing back here. All right, so you tell me. I've already been drawing a little bit, but tell me what we're supposed to draw here.
A dragon.
A dragon. I'll draw the lady.
Seven horns.
I'll draw the lady, right? She's crying out because she's about to have a baby, and it's not comfortable to have a baby. She's got this big belly. So there she is, and she's crying out. And then we have a dragon. What color is the dragon?
Red.
Red. And what does it look like?
It has 7 heads and 7 horns.
Seven heads. All right. We're going to, since we got to draw a lot of heads, we're going to do triangle heads. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right. And now I'm going to get the other red. And you got to draw angry eyes because it's an angry dragon. So you just draw pointy eyebrows, and that makes it angry, right? And then you gotta draw teeth on a dragon, because otherwise, what's the point of it being a dragon?
It has to have teeth. Dragons always have teeth.
Because that's what dragons do. They bite stuff.
It could be a super big lizard.
All right, so it's got teeth. And then, okay, so then but it's one big body. It's a, I don't know how we're gonna draw that, but there it is. There it is. It's on its feet, and there we go. So it's this big dragon. All right. Actually, I'm not gonna draw that. I'll take the body off because we might need to draw some other things. What else? It has seven heads, and what else?
Seven horns.
Not seven.
No.
10 horns. So we'll put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Isn't that kind of interesting? It's a different number of horns. And it is wearing 7 diadems. What's a diadem again? You remember what a diadem is? It's a crown. So you got to give it horns and crowns. I don't know how you're going to fit all that on its head. It gets kind of messy head. All right. So that's what this guy kind of looks like. And how big is his tail? Do you remember?
Super big.
The tail was big enough that it took down exactly what did it say? And his tail takes a third of the stars from heaven. So the sky is full of stars, but this guy is so big, his tail can knock stars out of the sky.
Whoa.
So there's his tail, and if he's a dragon, you gotta have a spiky tail, right? So we'll draw a spiky tail, and that's him swinging his giant spiky tail, and it's breaking the stars, and here's a star falling down, and here's a star falling down. So that's a crazy big dragon. And is he in a good mood and a happy thing?
No.
No. One of the reasons we know it is because, well, number one, he's a dragon. If it was a happy monster, it wouldn't have been a monster. Okay, so let's keep reading. Now we're getting a little bit of what's going on.
Yes.
All right. And the dragon stood before the woman who was about to have the baby. And when she was delivered, when she has the baby, he was going to devour the child. All right. What's the dragon want to do?
Eat it.
He wants to eat her baby.
Okay.
So that's a pretty nasty dragon. I'll draw some horns on it. There it is. And it's ready to eat the baby. Oh, I've got to give it angry eyes, right? There we go. There we go. So there's the dragon. He's going to try to eat the baby. All right, now I'm going to keep reading in verse 5. And when she delivered her son, a man-child, who is to rule all the nations with a rod of iron, and her child was caught up to God and to his throne. So did she have her baby?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So I'm drawing the baby. Babies are fat, and they have, like, the one hair, right? But what does it say that the baby is going to do?
Rule.
He's going to rule. So you have to draw this little baby with, like, you know, wearing a diaper, I guess, because he's a baby. And there's his hand and his little feet. He's also going to rule with what? With a rod of?
Iron.
Do babies usually hold rods of iron?
No.
No. So here's this little baby, but he's going to hold a rod of iron, and he's a ruler And what happens? He is caught up unto God, into his throne. So what happens to the baby? Does the dragon eat the baby?
No.
No. The baby is saved. And remember, we drew the throne just the other day, so that I can use that throne right, or not the throne, but the temple. So there's the baby, and it goes up to God. Okay, we're going to stop here for a moment. Who does this sound like? Who is this baby supposed to be?
Jesus.
Yeah. There's a lot of people. There's a lot of people who argue about, well, this thing in the Bible means this. And this thing, nope, it means this. No, it means this. Everybody. Everybody agrees this baby is Jesus. That's pretty good. I'm glad that people agree on that. There's even passages in the Bible that talk about Jesus ruling with a rod of iron. So it's almost like we've stopped the book of Revelation and we've gone all the way back to the birth of Jesus. Who do you think is the dragon that wants to eat Jesus?
Satan.
Yeah. We could say that this lady is Mary, his mother. You could almost say it's even the Jewish people. We don't know exactly, you know, it doesn't say for sure who and what she is, but that's kind of the idea here. Got to give her longer hair. And so here we have this story that we're going all the way back to the birth of Jesus now. All right. So is Jesus safe and with God?
Yes.
Yes. How do you think this guy's going to feel?
Angry.
Yeah. Sad.
Hungry.
Verse 6.
Hungry.
And the woman, he didn't get to eat the baby. Now who do you think he's going to try to eat?
The woman.
And the woman fled into the wilderness, where she had a place prepared of God, that they might nourish her for 1,260 days. Did we see that number before? 60 means 60. Have we seen 1,260 before? Do you know how many years that is?
3.5.
3.5 years. All right. And where did the woman go? The woman ran
to the wilderness.
Yep, to the wilderness. This is her running. Well, actually, it looks like she's flying. Oh, well. That's supposed to be her running. And there's her hair going back, and she's just running as fast as she can to get out to the wilderness, away from the dragon. Okay, so she's going to go out there. How do you think the dragon feels about that?
Hungry.
Mm-hmm.
Hungry.
And there was war in heaven. Michael and his angels going forth to war with the dragon. And the dragon warred with his angels. And so this is a pretty cool picture. So you can draw here, you know, a hand holding a sword and an angel, and he's fighting. And you got to draw wings because it's an angel, right?
It kind of looks like the death angel that killed Ramsey's son.
Yeah, that's a good point. Because there are angels that would kill those. You know, there's been angels that did that kind of thing before, aren't there? And so who are these angels fighting this time?
Satan.
Yep, they're fighting Satan. There's his tail.
Scary Satan.
Yep, you can throw in his tail, put some spiky-doos on his tail. I only drew three. The picture stopped. I only drew three heads because I didn't have space. But you can draw some angels and some swords. And it says even that the dragon has his own bad angels with him. So you could really do a lot. I'll draw just a spear because it's easier to draw. You could really draw a lot of people and a lot of fighting in this scene. Okay. So Michael and his angels go forth to war with the dragon, and the dragon warred with his angels. and they prevailed not, neither was their place found any more in heaven. And the great dragon was cast down, the old serpent, he that is called the devil and Satan, the deceiver of the whole world. He is cast down to earth, and his angels were cast down with him. We get a lot of names here. So now we know exactly. Did you guys guess that this dragon was Satan?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. You're right. He's called the great dragon. He's called the serpent. Why is he called the serpent, do you think?
Because he was that when Eve got deceived.
Right. He's called the devil. He's called Satan. He's called the deceiver. Because he deceives and he lies and he accuses people and he tries to get people to sin and he tries to get people in trouble and he is awful. And what happens when they fight? Who wins?
God
and his angels. And if the bad angels and Satan lose, what do you think happens?
He gets killed.
He gets punished.
He doesn't get killed yet. It says here he's cast down. I'll draw that in just a second, okay? He's cast down. All right, so now I'm going to read starting in verse 10. And I heard a great voice. A new page. I heard a great voice in heaven saying, now is come the salvation and the power and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his Christ. For the accuser of our brethren is cast down, which accuses them before God day and night. And they overcame him because of the blood of the Lamb and because of the word of the testimony. And they loved not their life even unto death. Therefore rejoice, O heavens, and you that dwell in them. Woe for the earth and for the sea, because the devil is gone down to you, having great wrath, knowing he hath but a short time. And so this is a happy rejoicing. I'll put rejoice. This is a happy rejoicing of salvation and power and the kingdom of God. Why are they happy?
Because Satan's dead.
Well, he's not dead, but he is cast down.
He's cast down.
So I'm going to draw this dragon getting cast down. And I'll draw that he has wings. And that's good to draw since he's getting cast down. That means even though he has wings, he can't fly. So here he is. He's going, oh, no, I'm getting cast down. And he's fallen. And his angels, too, right? Remember how he had some angels with him?
Mm-hmm.
And they're falling down, too. Oh, no. And so all these people are falling down from the battle in heaven. What does that mean? Where are they going to land? Where do you think they're going to land if they're falling down from heaven?
On earth.
So you can draw the earth down here if you want. Is that happy times for the earth?
No, buddy.
I mean, we're glad Satan's losing, but if he's going down here, that's kind of uncomfortable. But think about this. If Satan is falling down, he's going to be an ugly guy, but it also means he's the loser, right?
Mm-hmm.
If he's a loser, do we have to be afraid of him?
No,
he's the loser. He's already lost. We don't have to worry about that. It also says that the children of God overcame him, and it lists two things how we can overcome Satan. The first is the blood of the Lamb. You can draw some drops of blood. Right? Because Jesus died and we are washed in his blood in baptism and we can be saved. And it also says, because of the word of their testimony. That could be the word of God. It does say the word of their testimony, so it might be the words that we would do in our preaching or that we would confess that we love God. I don't know exactly how to interpret that. I need to think about that a little bit. But The dragon is falling. Actually, let me zoom out. The dragon is falling, and that's scary for Earth, but you know what? We have the blood of the Lamb. We have the word of the testimony. We're going to overcome. We're going to overcome. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Now, he does say, woe for the earth and for the sea, because, you know, who's fallen down to the earth and to the sea. I mean, watch out. This is going to be pretty rough time. I'll draw some spikelies on his back. We got to watch out, but he is the loser. All right, so now I'm going to draw here. Okay, I'm going to start reading again, okay? And when the dragon saw that he was cast down to earth, he persecuted the woman. Remember her? He persecuted the woman that brought forth the man-child. And there was given unto the woman two wings like a great eagle, that she might fly into the wilderness unto her place, where she is nourished for time, times, and half a time from the face of the serpent. So, is she going to be okay?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Now, if she has to run away, that means she's scared, right?
Mm-hmm.
But if she's given these wings, even if she's scared, she knows that she's going to be okay, right?
Yeah.
Give her some long hair. Oh, she only has one arm. Let me draw another arm. There we go. And I'll give her another wing back there. So she's going to be okay. Now, do you think she's happy that she has to run away?
No.
No. But do you think she's happy that God helps her run away?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. That's kind of like what we are right now. Do you guys enjoy the coronavirus?
No.
No. But are you happy that God is helping you out during it?
Yes.
Yeah. We still get our little Zoom Bible classes, and we can see our friends, and we all have food right now. Some people are really suffering, but I think God's taking care of us. Look at how long she's cared for. I think this is funny. She's nourished for a time, times with an S, and a half a time. Let's do some funny revelation math, okay? If we say that a time is one, then that means times is more than one, it's two. What is one half time? What do you get when you add those together? One plus two plus one half.
One.
We get three and a half again.
That's how many years.
Oh.
She was...
Remember how that funny number three and a half keeps showing up? Here it is again. Time times and a half. I just think that's a funny little moment. So again, time times and half a time. Is 3.5 years a long time?
Yeah.
When you're running away for your life, that's a long time. But is it forever?
No.
It's not at all forever. So she does have to run away, and it's not fun for her, but she's going to be okay. Okay, let's keep reading. And the serpent, wait a minute. The serpent? Where did the serpent come from?
No.
I think the dragon is also the serpent all of a sudden. Have you ever had a dream and something changes in the middle of your dream, but it, if it was real life, it wouldn't make sense, but since it's a dream, okay, it's okay? I think that that's what's going on here. I think the dragon and the serpent are the same person. And the serpent cast out of his mouth after the woman water like a river, that he might cause her to be carried away by the stream. Ooh, this is fun. So now you got to draw the dragon, his teeth. And he's not just opening his mouth to bite her this time. What's he doing this time?
He's in the river.
He's spitting out a river. Like a flood, right?
Mm-hmm.
All this water. That's pretty scary, right?
Mm-hmm.
Let's see what happens.
Are y'all having a bad connection on that end, or is it just us?
We're kind of in and out, but our internet is spotty.
We're fine.
Okay. Yeah, I think we're okay.
Yeah, I'm fine too.
Okay.
Ooh, there's a cool song. All right.
Get off.
Okay, so he's cast out that river. I'm going to keep going in verse 16 now, okay? And the earth helped the woman, and the earth opened her mouth and swallowed up the river, which the dragon cast out of his mouth. So now you can draw the earth. Draw the earth, and here's South America, and there's North America. Then you draw eyes and a mouth wide open to drink up all the water. This is one of my favorite drawings to draw. I don't know why. I just think it's so funny to draw the earth drinking up all of Satan's river water.
Wow. That's awesome.
Kiss us.
So the first thing that happens is she's given wings like an eagle that she can fly away, and she's cared for 3.5 years. He tries to get her with river water spit, and the earth drinks up the river water. Are all these things terrible that's happening to her?
Yeah.
But is she okay?
Yes. Yeah.
Even if the terrible things happen to her, she's okay?
Yep.
Yeah.
So what does that mean if the terrible things happen to us?
Okay.
We can be okay. They might be terrible, but we can be okay. And the dragon waxed wroth, which is just super old-fashioned language for that dragon got really stinking angry. I'll underline waxed wroth, because that's a fun thing. Next time you get angry, you could tell somebody, I am waxing wroth, and see what they say to you. The dragon waxed wroth with the woman and went to make war with the rest of her seed or the rest of her children, which keep the commandments of God and hold the testimony of Jesus. Who is he going to fight against now?
The children.
The children of whom?
The woman.
Yep. So she had the one baby, right?
Mm-hmm.
And what happened to that big-cheeked baby?
He went up to God.
He went up to God. And we said that that baby is Jesus, right?
Mm-hmm. But
it also says that she has other children. Who are these people?
The children?
Yeah, who are they? They're her children.
They're kind of like the apostles.
Could be like the apostles. It did say that she had a crown of 12 stars in her head, on her head. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And that's like 12 apostles. Oh, you can't see my 12 stars. I think, let's see how these children are described. He's going to fight against the children or her seed, right? These are the people who keep the commandments of God and hold the words of Jesus. So who is the kind of person that keeps God's commandments and the words of Jesus?
For children and Christians.
Right, right. And so I think what that means is us, right? So we have the little baby, but he got carried up to God, and we said that that's Jesus, right? And now there's just the rest of us down here. And that person's head is apparently the number 6.
And they can't be all men.
Oh, okay, sorry. I'll give some of them red hair. That's Anne Shirley right there.
Shirley? Who's Anne Shirley?
She lives in a house with Green Gables. Yeah. So here are her children, the people who obey God's commands, the people who listen to Jesus' words. This could be the people that had the mark that God put on their forehead, right? I did the, like the cross with a heart. Basically, these are the good people. What does that dragon want to do now?
Yeah.
Now here's the thing. Here's the thing. When the lady was getting attacked, was she able to escape?
Yes.
But did she have to run for her life?
No.
Yes, she did. But when the dragon came again, was she given wings to fly?
Yes.
But she still had to run away, right?
She had to fly for her life.
And when the dragon was going to drown her in a flood, was she saved?
Yes.
But the flood still came, right?
Yeah, the earth had to drink of its life.
So the earth got the water in it now.
Yeah? So if the dragon is going to come after you and me now, does that mean that we're always going to have sunshine and wonderful days and French fries and pigs in a blanket?
No. Pigs in a frying pan.
We're going to have hard times. We're going to have to watch out for the flood that the dragon might spit at us. He might knock down stars and make our life dark. Will we be able to survive?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Will some Christians maybe die?
Yes.
We have stories in the Bible of God's people dying, even the good ones, right? But even though they died.
Like David, he died.
But he died when he got old. But think about the people who got killed because they were Christians.
Like the people who are killed by Saul.
Well, even the people in the book of Acts. You have James, the first apostle who died. You had Stephen who died. You had people who died. But are we going to make it? Are we going to be okay even if the dragon comes after us?
Yes.
The idea. Now,
we're going to heaven.
That's the end of chapter 12. But when we get into chapter 13, we are going to learn, well, what's the dragon going to do? He tried eating the baby. He tried attacking the lady. He tried drowning her with water. What's he going to do for us? How is he going to try to come after us or the Christians who were alive when John wrote this book? What's he going to do with those Christians? And when we read through chapter 13, he's going to use two monster beasts. And so next week, we're going to get into two more, or next class time, we're going to get into two more monster beasts. So that's that. Any questions about what we read?
I have a question.
Yeah, bud, what's that?
I was wondering, I didn't know the dragon had with water in his mouth.
Well,
how did he get the water in his mouth? Or did he just have it in his mouth? Or
I thought that dragons spit out fire.
See, that's a funny thing. Yeah, I don't know why. In this vision, again, it's just a vision. It's a dream that God gave John to see. That's the way the dragon attacked. I don't know why. If he was big enough to knock stars out of the sky, why didn't he just eat the earth? But no, that's not the way it goes. It just says he tried to drown her. Maybe that means something. Maybe there was something specific that I don't understand about the story. I don't know. It's a neat question, though. Any other questions, guys? Guys and girls? Cool. Well, thanks a bunch, and I will talk to you again soon.